The new iPhone 15 Pro and Pro Max have a fantastic new feature called the Action button. It's a replacement for the ringer switch, which we are used to on the iPhone, sitting just above the up and down volume buttons. Now, Apple gives you the option to program this button with some default Apple commands, and you might have even already started using one of them. But those are kind of boring compared to what I built using the Shortcuts app. So let's show you how you can supercharge this action button feature to be the best productivity feature in iOS 17. Okay guys, so first I'm gonna show you what I created for my action button, my custom action button. So if I press on the action button there, you see I have a full menu of options. And you might notice that if you go through this menu here, it's very similar to what Apple has, but it's all in one. So if you go into the settings app and then down to the action menu, you can see that starting from the beginning here, you can only select one of these options for your device. So you have silent mode, focus mode, which you can only select, like if I want to go into work mode, or work focus mode, you can only go into that mode when you tap on the action button. It doesn't create a menu. And I'll talk about that in just a second. Camera, I can select which kind of mode I want to open up the camera app to. Flashlight, pretty self-explanatory. Voice memo, start a voice memo right away. Magnifier brings up that feature. And then shortcuts, you can select which shortcut you want to run. Mine is action button set for now. And then accessibility, you can go into this menu and select which accessibility option you want to choose from. Again, doesn't give you a menu option to select from multiple. And then you have no action. So let's go into the shortcuts feature here for the action button, and I'll show you what I programmed with my specific action button. So as you can see here, we have the full menu of everything you just saw. And if I go into something like set focus, I now have a separate menu asking me which focus I want to toggle on and off. As you saw before, you can only select one with Apple's standard one, and with mine, you can select three. So I'm gonna back out of that, and then let's go into accessibility. Again, a full menu of options just so you don't have to leave it to one. I can toggle like assistive touch on, and then if I go back into that menu, I can go ahead and toggle it off. So that's essentially what I created. If you go into the Shortcuts app, you can see here in my action button shortcuts, there's like a full list here and then all of these options that I created. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to link this down in the video description down below so you can download it and then you can modify it to your liking. So you can readjust these to where you want, or you can go ahead and change the emojis, whatever you want to do, add functions, whatever you want to do, you can do it and you don't have to start completely from scratch. But for you guys that want to learn exactly how I did that, let's go ahead and teach you exactly how I made that menu. So let's go into this here. I'll show you how to create mute toggle and set focus just to save a little bit of time and not go throughout the full process because that's a little long. So first, let's create that mute toggle switch. So what I'm going to do is to create that menu option that you saw, I'm going to go ahead and add app option or add action. Yep, that's what it is. And then type in menu in the search. And you're going to be looking for choose from menu under the scripting options. Perfect. And I'm going to name my prompt test. And then I'm going to put a little emoji here. Perfect. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to name the first one mute toggle. Perfect. And why don't I go ahead and add something like that. That's what I used before. And then the second one, I'm going to name focus. Yes, that's a good one. So focus, and let's go back, put a little emoji there. Let's do something different. I'll just put this in. Perfect. Perfect. So those are now my two menu options. And if you see here, two menu options, test, mute toggle, focus. So now we have to add some substance to those menu options so that they actually have something that you can do. So for the first one, we're going to be doing the mute toggle. So we're going to go ahead and go to the search bar here. It's pretty easy. We're going to go ahead and type in silence, and you can just search it. And then under scripting, you're going to look for set silent mode. Perfect. And as you can see here, it's added to the bottom. We're gonna drag this underneath mute toggle so that it's under that menu option. So one thing that you wanna do here is you can select turn silent mode on or off, but what I do is I actually set this as a toggle. And that toggles so it goes on and off, just like the ringer switch that you had before. Toggle is really something that you want to use more than just turn it on or off, because then you only have the option to turn it on and you don't have an option to turn it off. So this is kind of the easiest way where you can toggle. You can also ask it have it ask you each time, but that's kind of annoying. It takes more time. So I just set it to toggle. And as you can see, if I go ahead and run this, mute toggle, you can see that my mute or my silencer changed there. Let's go ahead and run it again. And now it's on. You can see at the top there. Perfect. So now we're going to go ahead and do a little bit harder one. It's focus. So let's go ahead and type in focus here. Search. And then we're going to go ahead and set focus under scripting. Okay. So we're going to drag this underneath focus. That's where it needs to be. And then you want to select toggle again if you want to be able to toggle on and off. If you want to turn do not disturb off or any of these like on, off, whatever, you can do that. But I prefer toggle. That's how I created mine. And that's the way I like it. And what I did was you can toggle specific ones, just like the Apple one where you just select only one, or you can actually have it ask each time. The way I created it was ask each time simply because it gives you all three options that I have set for my focus. And I know people with like eight options. So it would be cool to be able to toggle whatever you want and have it ask you each time versus just toggling one single focus mode. So that's how I created that. Pretty simple, pretty easy. And if I go ahead and run it, focus, work plus, I have three options here. I'm going to do work plus. And as you can see, it's on. I'm going to go back in, focus, work plus, and it's off. So those are our two options. I'm going to go ahead and change. Let's change the icon here to something a little cool. Let's just go ahead and change it to that and then set it to this color. Boom, done. And as you can see here, we have a choose from menu option. I'm going to name this, what am I gonna name this? Test, perfect. Okay, and then what you wanna do is go into the settings app and we're gonna assign that whole script that we just made, it's under test, to the action button. So now, when I hold on to that action button, this is what we just created, pretty simple. Pretty easy. And now I can just go ahead and select through multiple options versus being limited to one, which is what Apple has as their default setting. Now, if you want to create something, like for me, going through that menu is kind of, I don't know. I have a lot of those options in the control center here. So some of those options aren't really useful to me. But what I really find the action button useful for is creating things that I can kind of press and do in my pocket without ever having to look at the screen, like something I can kind of do like incognito. So I'm going to show you exactly what I set up, which is really cool and something that I actually have been using, because it's like when you're in conversation, you want to kind of leave and then you precondition your car. I have a Tesla. That's how I set mine up. So I'm going to show you exactly how I did that. So I go into add action and then we're going to search for Tesla. And you have a ton of options here. I'm so glad that Tesla kind of supports all this, but we're going to go ahead and search for preconditioned vehicle, start, stop. Now you can have it start, you can have it stop, or you can have it ask each time. I wish there was a toggle switch here, but there's just not yet. But you can have it ask each time, but essentially what that's going to do is it's going to prompt you on screen. So what I want to do is I want to start my preconditioning without ever looking at my device, just do it in my pocket. So I'm going to go ahead and start, select my vehicle. Perfect. Easy as that. Done. And, then when I go into settings, action button, I'm gonna go ahead and change that to what I created, which is preconditioned vehicle. So now if I just tap on that action button, I can turn my AC on, my heat on, wherever I am, through my pocket. I don't have to do anything else. Now, something a little bit more realistic for most people is, let's say you want to automate lights or do AC. You can also do that as well. So if you're at home and you want to turn the AC down to, let's say, a certain value, you can go ahead and do that. So just go into the Shortcuts app, add an action, and we are going to search for home. Perfect. And we're going to go into our home kind of like app here under the lab, which is my home. And then we're going to go ahead and select control. And what we're going to do is we're going to control certain things. So I can set this to, let's say I'm walking up to my door. I can actually set it as my Yale door lock. So my action button will open the door without me ever looking at the screen. That's pretty cool. So let's go ahead and do that. That's a little bit more exciting than turning on the air. So let's do that. Yale front door. And then let's go ahead and set that to unlock. Perfect. So set Yale front door to unlock. Done. We're going to rename this to unlock door. Perfect. Unlock door. Boom. Switch it over. And where's unlock door? Right there. And then I can just go ahead, run this, and my door will be unlocked. So that's kind of cool. I can use that if I'm walking up to my door and you know, I don't want to pull my phone out and go throughout the whole process. So that's pretty cool. And yeah. It's just, I heard it there, my door unlocked, and it's pretty easy to do. Just, you know, set any one of those settings. You can set it to air. You can set it up to like AC. You can set it up to control your lights through HomeKit, anything you want. You can send out a tweet. As I said, right here, I set up one where I can do like, I'm tweeting that I'm uploading a video or something like that. You can set this action button to do pretty much anything you want. And if you go and build something, add action, you have so many options here. These are just like the preset ones. You can go in and go into all actions. There's a ton that you can do with the action button, and you can set it all to that one button and kind of customize it how I showed you. Now, one last thing that I wanted to show you guys is a lot of people like to use Google Assistant versus Siri. So what I'm going to do is show you how to do that. You add action, type in assistant, boom, done. Hey Google, show when run. We're gonna turn that off. That took probably 10 seconds at most. So now I'm in the Hey Google menu and I can do anything I want here. And it actually automatically opened the Hey Google prompt there, and I can speak into it just as fast as I would Siri. That's pretty darn cool.
Okay, so that's the action button and what you can do to make it one of the best features on the new iPhone. Let me know in the comments what you do with yours and if you use Apple's default commands or you make one of your own in the Shortcuts app. Now, before you go, remember that those two automations we built today are available via the link in the video description. So if you don't want to start completely from scratch, check out those and get a head start on your custom action button shortcut.